I still want to be an astronaut when I grow up, but ever since I was about 4, I've wanted to be an astronaut, and that's kind of what led me on this path. I grew up on Capitol Hill, right down the street from the Air and Space Museum on the Mall, and I can remember so many different times going there on weekends or school trips, and I was obsessed with the space room and the planets. That helped me hold on to that dream that I had since I was 4. I wasn't just a kid who, when they were 4, they wanted to be an astronaut. I realized that I could actually be an astronaut, maybe, fingers crossed, if I work really hard. The main ones who have encouraged me since day one, because they were able to, were my parents, and they're the reason why I see learning as just curiosity and finding out things about things I'm interested in. It's not a chore. School has never been a huge effort or a bore to me because I've been taught from an early age that everything can be fun if you find the cool part about it. It's so important to have female role models. Seeing females in the roles that you hope to be in one day is necessary for little girls to see that and realize that they can be that too. I love doing STEM outreach, specifically with girls, but also boys too, telling them, take what you're passionate about and turn it into a career, because then it doesn't feel like work. You enjoy every day at your job. I like to say I get to pretend to be an astronaut every day. As a human factors systems engineer on a spacecraft, while I help the engineers design a spacecraft that will actually work for people, we're taking humans to space and not just cargo, so we need to make sure that everything in the spacecraft works for the human. So I get to go in our mock-up, I get to fly a simulator, make sure that everything actually works the way an astronaut needs it to work, which makes me just feel like an astronaut every day. Communicating is so important, especially in a field like STEM. I think a lot of people have misconceptions about what it means to be in science, technology, engineering, and math. And I have heard that from other people. You know, you don't look like an engineer. What does an engineer look like? I think I look like an engineer because I am one. So I think communicating and just educating people around you who may not understand what you do, may not understand why you want to do it, and just saying, I do really cool stuff. You might be interested in it too. Here's what I do, here's why I do it, and explaining that it's not some lofty, crazy thing that people do on computers, only coding all the time. It really is a business about people and working with people, and communication is a key. My name is Celena Dopart, and I'm a human factors systems engineer